David Hyde O'Brien, class of 1959. I have a couple of letters I'd like to read before the introduction of David. On behalf of the Board of Directors, the National Office, and all the members of the NFL alumni around the country, we'd like to offer our congratulations to Dave on his induction into the Watertown High School Hall of Fame. We always take great pride when one of our own is recognized and honored for his past accomplishments. We are sure that this evening will be a very memorable one for Dave for many years to come. It is with great pride that we again offer our congratulations for an honor well deserved. We hope that you have a great evening. Randy Minear, Chairman of the Board, National Football League alumni. Also, congratulations on your acceptance into the Watertown High School Hall of Fame. I'm certain the best lesson you received at Watertown was when you followed the advice of your school guidance counselor not to pursue a career as a professional card player, but to stick to football instead. Man, your card playing was so bad, I always thought you were from Marblehead, not Watertown. All kidding aside, it's great for your town to be honoring one of their own. All of your teammates at BC are equally proud from one of Dave's teammates at Boston College, Tom Hall. I guess when David was first informed of his induction into the Watertown Hall of Fame, the first question he asked was why. And, you know, David, one of the easy answers is, of all the athletes that went through Watertown High, David O'Brien had the longest major league professional career of anyone. But he started off in a very inauspicious way. He was a baseball player and a basketball player at the West Junior High School. He was also a hockey player, participated in track and field, but never really had much of an interest in football. And it wasn't until his senior year, he was a state shot put champion as a senior, but it was until his senior year that Frank Salito, who was an assistant coach on the football team, sparked an interest in this big guy to join this undermanned, sophomore, loaded football team. This team that you are going to see honored tonight in 1960, we were all sophomores in the 1959 team, the 58 team. And David played his first year of varsity football as an offensive and a defensive lineman in a team that won one game, lost seven, and tied one, including a legendary game in Watertown High history when Archie McGee of Brockton almost won the state scoring championship by himself on one day in a 78-12 victory over Watertown. And I think that O'Brien thought he was on the track team and not on the football team, chasing McGee up and down the field. But you know, there was a very interesting game that year, and I don't think it's ever happened before in the history of high school football in Massachusetts. The only game we won that year was against Matignon High School, 14-12. There were five NFL football players on the field in that game. Dave O'Brien from Watertown playing his first high school varsity season. Bob Capodanno from Watertown, who would later play 3 years in the NFL, Hall of Famer, playing his first varsity season. Artie Graham from Matignon High School, Cambridge. Don McKinnon from Matignon High School, All-American at Dartmouth. And the third guy was a great, great football player who would later play for the Boston College and the Chicago Bears named Jack Concannon. Five NFL football players on the field in one afternoon at Victory Field in Watertown. I don't think it has ever happened before. After that senior year at Watertown High School, he went on to Boston College. Coach Palladino was influential in talking to his former teammate Mike Hollaback into giving this big rangy kid who could run like the Dickens a chance. And he could run like the Dickens. He had great speed, great range, but hadn't as yet filled out. But did he fill out by spring practice of his freshman season? He got better and better and better at Boston College until finally awarded a football scholarship. By 1961, Ernie Heffley, the coach at Boston College, was calling Dave O'Brien, who played his first year of high school football 2 years before, our best defensive tackle. Following a 14-10 upset over Iowa State, Dave was voted the mainstay of the defensive line for Boston College. A knee injury in preseason hampered the start of Dave's senior year in 1962, and the team stalled. Syracuse, Navy, beat the Boston College Eagles. But Dave returned to the lineup against Houston, sparking a 14-0 shutout, and BC would not lose another game. In the season finale against rival Boston Holy Cross, Boston College romped 48-12. Press noted that Holy Cross could not block Dave O'Brien. Dave was an all-New England pick, was invited to play in the East-West All-Star Crusade Bowl, drafted by the New England Patriots, and also by Minnesota in the National Football League draft, one of only eight New England players that was tabbed by the NFL draft that season. He signed with the Minnesota Vikings and made the squad. Dave stayed in the NFL for six seasons, playing for the Minnesota Vikings, the New York Giants, and the St. Louis Cardinals, before a leg injury stopped his playing career. He joined the Bank of New England, rose to senior vice president over the course of a 20-plus year career. In 1992, he became president of Century Management Holding Corporation, a commercial real estate company in Boston. Dave earned his MBA from Northeastern and finally went to a good school, earning his graduate banking degree from Rutgers in 1978. As important as Dave's role has been in athletics and in business, he's a charter member of the NFL alumni group Caring for Kids and the organization's New England chapter president. Dave has worked to raise money for children's charities, including the Mass Adoption Resource Exchange, whose board he chaired for a decade. David was selected for the Boston College Hall of Fame in 1985, but it's particularly fitting that he be honored here tonight for his achievements as an athlete. Dave had a tragedy in his family last week when his mother passed away. I was going through the records of the Hall of Fame and noticed that Dave was first nominated for the Hall of Fame by a letter from his mom the first year the Hall of Fame had an induction. He's one of our all-time greats. Ladies and gentlemen, David Hyde O'Brien, class of 1959.
Thank you very much, Mr. Kaprielian. First and foremost this evening, I would like to thank the committee for including me in such a distinguished group of inductees in the 1996 class of the Watertown High School Athletic Hall of Fame. It is an honor that I will certainly cherish forever. When Bobby Cappadoni called me to inform me of my selection to the Hall of Fame, as Bob Naughton said, my first reaction was, why? Cappy didn't get pushed off guard, and he said, certainly, Dave, it wasn't for anything you did at Watertown High School. Well, that made me feel a little better. So he said that the committee had really broadened the scope of people who would be eligible, and they thought they'd include some late bloomers. So I thank Bob, and I truly was flattered to be included in such a distinguished class of people. Upon reflection, however, it became clear to me that I should accept this award this evening on behalf of my coaches, my teachers, the administrators of Watertown High School. It is they who I think played a central role in my development as a person, not only athletically, but academically, socially, morally, as they did with so many other people who came before me and after and are yet to come. It was they who built the strong foundation to prepare all of the students for life after Watertown High School. Last night, I attended a dinner where Jack Connors, president of Hill Holiday, was honored as the Humanitarian of the Year by the Ron Burton Training Village. It's a camp that primarily caters to inner children, inner city children who are 8 to 16 years old. And in this camp, Ron Burton gives all of the campers all new clothes. They're all sweats, t-shirts, shorts, even sneakers. All of these clothes are inscribed with the words peace, love, humility, and peace.